Hello, machinist. How are you? It's getting cooler and cooler in Japan. How is it in your country? I have to go eat shaved ice while it's still hot. Do you have shaved ice in your country? Please let me know in the comment section. Oops, a letter has arrived. We've separated the Japanese and English channels from this time. Japanese, please go to the Japanese channel. Please check it. It's been such a cool day recently, but I have a hot topic to offer you today. I'm often asked in various places, I want to buy a Nakamura-Tome machine. Which one do you recommend? This is a hard question for company owner. I love every machine, but I think there's a machine that matched with the workpiece you want to process and your requirement. Every time we suggest the best machine for the workpiece, for the machining. So I'd like to introduce our lineup to make it easier for you to select a machine. Let's have fun with it. First of all, here's a simple classification. 1 turret, 2 turret, and 3 turret. Then there are the type of turrets, have B axis, and the machine with 2 spindle. Yes, actually, that's all. Isn't it easy? Did you think Nakamura-Tome had 100 different types of machine? It's surprisingly simple. Let's start with single turret machine. Single turret machines are, after all, simple at easy to use. I think there are many people who start with this machine. Nakamura-Tome's machines are especially characterized by their high machining capability. No need for words, right? Great sound and great chips. 8mm cutting depth, very stable machine. The ability to perform such heavy-duty cutting means that machine can perform stable and accurate machining of severe cutting condition and cutting process. Also, it means stable for machining difficult cutting materials such as hardened steel and heat-resistant alloys. Of course, both tailstock and second spindle can be selected. You can choose a specification according to what you want to do. Next, let's move on to a machine with 2 turrets. Recently, the combination of 1 upper turret and 1 lower turret is very popular. The most attractive feature of 2 turret is simultaneous machining. Since there are 2 spindles on both sides, machining both sides together will be that much faster. There's a time called cycle balance. If the machining time differs by 20 seconds between the left and right spindle, what happens to the turret that finish earlier? Rest or work? The turret is a very hard worker. The one that finish earlier can help the one that takes longer. This time, instead of simultaneous left and right machining, it's upper and lower machining at the same time. Not only OD and OD, but also grooving and ID can be done at the same time. Various processing can be done at the same time. It's interesting, isn't it? A 2-turret machine is called double D. That upper turret has Y-axis and the lower turret has no Y-axis. A machine with both Y-axis is called double Y. It's easy to remember. Now we have 1 more turret. It's a machine with 3 turret. It's a lot of tools. Have you ever noticed this? When the upper and lower turret are machining at the same time, what happened to the spindle on the right side? It's resting. Don't you want to move it and shorten the cycle time more? Let me give you another turret. 3-turret machines can do work both of the left and right side even when 2 turret are machining up and lower side simultaneously. It's a machine that minimizes loss time. The lower can also provide support help machining this way. Here's useful for center support. How many tools do you think attached to the machine? Nakamura-Tome machine have 12 milling tool per turret or 15 depending on the specification. On typical model, 24 stations are available with intermediate indexing for turning tool. This means that 40 or 70 tools can be mounted on a multi-turret machine. This is like number of tools mounted on a ATC machine, is it? Of course, this machine is also used for medium-sized mass production, but it's also used in high-mix low-volume production by installing several types of tools in advance to ease the setup and changeover process. This is called permanent tooling. It's a cool name, isn't it? Now, from here, I would like to introduce machine with B-axis. I personally like to see the B-axis in motion. Okay, let's go to the B-axis turret. It's unique to have B-axis on turret machine, is it? The good thing about this machine is that B-axis can process at different angle, so it's very good at milling slanted hole and sloping surface. And the fact that it can be done with a turret machine means that there's no need to go to the magazine to get the tool. It's a difference with tool spindle machine, so machining can be done quickly. Now, let's take a look at the tool spindle machine. This machine had the tool spindle which allow fast and powerful milling. It's great feature. The B-axis allow for high degree of freedom in machining and complex machining such as this. Recently, gear skiving is also a popular machining method. This type machining is ideal for machines like this, where the tool spindle tilted and the spindle rotation is synchronized with the tool rotation in this process. On the left side is the magazine. This magazine can hold up to 120 tools, which reduces the tooling setup time. Of course, there are some models, larger and smaller. And if you look at the lower, you can choose from model without lower, with a single lower turret, with two lower turret, according to your need. Now, what do you think? We introduce them powerfully and quickly as Nakamura-Tome machine. It's very distinctive and interesting. Oops, I received another letter. Did you introduce my favorite machine properly? It's a message from our team member. It seems that many of us love machine, and each of them has her favorite model. Now, which one is your favorite model? If you like this video, please register and click like button. Oh, it's time. I need to go to eat my final shaved ice at this season. Maybe today is green tea flavor. See you soon, machinist. Bye.